Hello everyone and welcome to the video. Today we have something pretty exciting in stock for me. You guys might not care as much, but it has something to do with this. Now this is the key fob to my car. This button is like caved in. This is my secondary key fob, the one that I use right now as my regular key fob. The button did the same thing and I had to tape it down. So what I have in this package is a brand new key fob. Now it's not cut and it's not programmed or anything. If I take both this one apart and this one apart, I can take the internals of this and put it in the shell of this one. We're gonna see, and I don't know what I'm doing, so it's definitely gonna be interesting. So yeah, let's get started. So the new key fob comes in this little bag, and then it comes in another bag, and it's got the fob itself. It's got a tiny little screw, and it's got the bow tie, which it looks like it's got some like adhesive cover over the back. It's blank back there, and I'm assuming you're supposed to like put the screw through this tiny hole right here, and then you put the little bow tie over that. I'm not gonna put the bow tie on yet, but you can see it works very nice. The key is not cut, that's why I'll have to take the part from this one, the little key part, and the internals, and put it in this one. So, let's get started. I'm kind of nervous, I'm not gonna lie, because I don't know what I'm doing. But I think you can just take the back off, and then, I don't know if you just pry it. All right, so I looked it up just to be sure, and they said to take the battery out, and then they said use a flathead screwdriver. I mean, nail clippers will do just fine, right? We'll see. And they said to put it in this little crack here and pry it up. It's already broken, right? I ain't that worried. All right, I got a butter knife. I'm just gonna try and get in here. I think I almost got it. So you can see it's starting to like pull apart like that. So we got it all apart. This is the shell and everything. We got that one apart. Now we just have to get the other one apart. So I'm gonna set these here so that I know what goes to what. And we move on to the new one. That came off a lot easier. This is much nicer. Oh, it just came right apart. Oh my God. Okay, well there you go. That was easy as hell. I should probably clean this off first. All right, so I cleaned up the key. The key looks good. It's nice and clean. So all you gotta do is you put the board in. You put the key in the open position. Put the spring in the back. Put the button over the spring. Line it up. Like that. And then you just twist it around twice. Make sure the board's in, otherwise you're doing nothing. And then you close it. Put the key in, this on the back, and there you go. Now this one doesn't fit perfectly, just because the old key thing doesn't fit right. I think I can find a way to fix it over time, but for now, this will work. And it looks nicer. So that's gonna be it for today. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'm pretty happy that I have a key that has buttons that work. So yeah, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe, and yeah, I'll see you next video. Gucci now, yeah, tell him Gucci now. She the apple of my eye and she gon' rock that new Chanel. I hear LA in the summer when the Barney's for the sale. Went from college dormitory, exclusive parties.